Yeah, sorry about that. Someone had called. I had to grab the phone. But anyway, let's get back to it. So, Robzilla is vehemently denying that he's changed Big Lenny's password to his YouTube so that Lenny could not have access to it. So he's vehemently denying that. So tonight we're extending an invitation to Lenny to either come on here live or to go live on his YouTube proving Lenny wrong. Somebody is lying. Okay? Rob is vehemently denying that he's the reason why Lenny doesn't have access to his YouTube. I want Lenny to, let's see if Lenny proves him wrong. Let's see if Lenny comes on here live. Let's see if Lenny does a live on his YouTube. Somebody's lying. That's another thing. Rob is claiming that Lenny is a crackhead. There's all these things. Lenny is welcome to come on here. He's welcome to, explain anything. Or he can go live on his own, thank you, Zach, but I'm still the same weight I was last week. I need to get back on track. This drinking this fucking beer doesn't help. And by the way, Rob, for some reason you're convinced that doxing where I work is gonna make me scared or bother me or anything like that. Anybody there? Anybody there? What's up, man?
Yo, what's up, Cuban, man?
What's going on? Where are you located?
UK, UK. Yo, listen, really? I just want to have a quick pop at this here. So obviously this whole Big Lenny situation with this Robzilla, yeah? He can't get any more advantage of, he thought he'd ride out, see what the money he can make on YouTube with Big Lenny and the Misfits and the whole Jason Genova. Now he sees that he's dying down. Now he's talking shit, just trying to basically get people's attention to him so he can make more money. He's a fucking bum. I'm sorry, but he's a fucking bum.
Here's the thing. Unlike the position that I'm in, and I explained this on one of the lives, I'm in this position that I can't do anything as far as the Misfits. I can't do anything lucrative. I got a YouTube page that only has like 165, 64, 66 subscribers. And because I talk about politics so much, it's not going to fucking go anywhere. My other two IG pages, they're not going to fucking go anywhere. I talk too much politics. So I'm in this position that people can see that I'm not trying to do anything to try to make any fucking money or gain more subscribers or anything like that. That was one of the things I said in the podcast. Me doing the podcast, I'm not going to get anything out of it. I didn't get any more subscribers. I didn't get any more followers. I got nothing on it.
Yeah, exactly. You wanted nothing to gain off it. But obviously, but when he moved down to, you know, near Lenny, and when he moved down to Florida or wherever the fuck he came from, you know, they all used to talk shit about him, but then now he knows he can't get anything off him, so now he's trying to shine the light towards him. Do you know what I mean? And trying to get money and this, that, and that. It doesn't work like that, man. You're a grown-ass man, abled human. You know, he's got no money left for gear. You know, I bet you Lenny was hooking him up with a lot of stuff. Well, it wasn't only, you know, people say Lenny's this and Lenny's that. Yeah, but Lenny's kind of past his prime. Deep down, he knows it as well. But obviously, everyone's got love for Lenny. You know, Brad's working hard. Jay's working hard. You're working hard. You're doing your thing. But Rob, like, what did he ever bring to the table? What, when Prince Andrew and Brad stopped filming for Lenny, yeah, Rob was there as, you know, filming him. But then what did he really bring to the table? With those shitty quality videos with all the wind in the background. You know what I mean? I don't get why he's now trying to poke at you, and he's poked at everyone in the past.
Here's the thing about Rob Zilla, and I'm going to reiterate this in case you don't know. This whole thing with me talking about him, this has to do with back in May of last year. And it wasn't the first time he had done it. But back in May of last year, my father's in the hospital, whom he died. My father was in the hospital on his deathbed. He was dying. And so Rob, out of nowhere, starts messaging me, and he wants me to let him know when's the next time Jay comes in town.
Yeah.
So that he could physically ambush him.
I didn't do it.
I refused to do it. And then all these threats, and I have all the DMs. I have everything. I have everything screenshotted. So that's where this stems from. And then I find out, when I let everyone know what happened, then I find out that Rob has done it to countless of people.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, exactly.
And I love it how it's almost as if he doesn't get that I can't go around talking like he's talking. Talking like I'm gonna kick your ass, I'm gonna do this, and I'm gonna do that. It would be very difficult to explain to the police why he's going to the hospital if I've been online threatening him, daring him to do something. So that's what he's not understanding. So he can call me a coward all he wants, and I don't want to meet him anywhere like that. Listen, this isn't junior high. You know, meet me by the fucking monkey bars and shit. I'm almost 50. I don't have time to go fucking meet anybody anywhere or fight anybody or like that. You know, if he wants to show up at my doorstep, if he wants to show up at my job, he's in for a rude awakening. So...
Yo, listen, do you know what? Yeah, I see him in comment now. He's on.
He has the Big Lenny Show IG.
Yeah. Why don't you go live with him and let's see what he's got to say.
Absolutely.
Yeah, man. Yo, listen, I'll chat to you another time, man. Yeah, talk to him, man. See what he's got to say. Take care, man.
You too.
Take care, man.
What's up, you fat pussy? What's it like being a fatso, dating some big fucking hippo, and having two ugly kids that you can barely afford to take care of because you work at fucking Publix? You want to say that I won't come to your address? Send me your address right now, and I'll be there. I'll be there tomorrow. I'll be there tonight. I'll show up. What are you going to do, shoot me? I can still fuck you up even with a gun. You're a fat fucking coward. Fat coward. I'm 30 minutes away. You want to run in here and talk shit with these losers? I'm right here, bro. You could have called me anytime. If you had a problem with me, you could have called me. But you run to YouTube, you run to Instagram, because you're a little bitch. Keep drinking that hops, you estrogen-soaked piece of shit. You know,
Rob, catch your breath. Catch your breath.
Fuck you.
Breathe.
Yeah, mister, I put 10 pounds on the hammer strength. Seeing you in the gym was the most pathetic display of a human being I've ever seen in my entire life. Your dad's Listen, Cuban, I'm happy your dad's dead. He's happy too because he doesn't have to have such a disappointment fat piece of fucking lard for a son anymore. You piece of shit. You want to start
That's it, Rob. Get it all out. No, get it all out, Rob. That's it.
I want you to be a man and meet me face to face and tell me what your problem is. Be a man. Don't go
No, Rob, you already
like
know what my
coward.
Problem is. My problem is I wouldn't fuck Jay over. You didn't fucking
coward.
Like it.
You're proving my point. You're a fucking coward.
And you're proving my point that you're a fucking retard, dude. You don't get it. The more you resist, the more you talk, the worse the fucking trolls are going to come after you. That's what you don't fucking get.
They're going to come after you for bitching out right now. Come meet me, bro. That's what they'd rather see. They'd rather see you come meet me. Then see you sit in the car drinking.
No, like I'm not stupid enough to do that. Rob, when was the last time you challenged someone your own age and your own size? When was the last time you did that?
That doesn't matter, bro. If you want to talk
shit, doesn't matter.
You're ready to get an ass.
I'm the fucking coward. I'm the pussy, and it doesn't matter.
Yeah, running your mouth and then backing down when somebody says meet up with me, that's a coward. There's no way around it. Don't try to sneak your way around this. You say I won't come to your address, send me your address right now. Send it. Send me your fucking address. I will rip your fucking head off, you fat piece of filth.
That's it. Let it all out. Let it all out.
Look at you. Look at you. You're a fucking fat loser. Look at you. Look at you, dude. You're embarrassing. Look at how many people you got in your life. 100. Because I'm in it talking shit. Otherwise, it'd be 10 people.
This is what everyone wanted. Everyone wanted you to come on here and blow a fucking gasket. This is what they wanted.
No, they want to see me fucking shove your face into the asphalt for being a fat fucking bitch.
Rob, you already know where I work. So
no, I don't. Because I called them today and you don't work at that one. So I had the wrong Publix.
Ah, too bad.
No, so I'll find out what works. I'm not going to show up to your work where you're going to be a little bitch, hide behind your coworkers, and go call the cops. Be a fucking man. No cops, no cameras, nothing. Be a fucking man. You got my number? Meet up
Everyone,
with me.
Everyone, take a look at this man and how angry he is. But he's the one that wanted me to fuck somebody over. He doesn't like me talking about it to anybody.
You know who
and his answer...
About? We're talking
His
about
His answer is to meet
person,
him somewhere face to face and find it out. I'm not a fucking retard. I'm not in fucking junior high. I'm not going to meet anybody on the fucking monkey bars.
Yeah, Abby, I'm not talking about the monkey bars. You're just finding ways to be a bitch and cop out. They all know it, bro. You're a fucking wuss.
Cop out to what? I never challenged you on anything.
I'm challenging you to meet me and talk to me face-to-face conversation.
There's nothing to talk about.
No fighting.
There's nothing to talk about. While my father was on my fucking deathbed, you fucking threatened me and you threatened my family. There's nothing to talk about.
Stop running your mouth about
me. There's nothing to talk about.
Clearly there is, because you go on here every day talking about me, so there clearly is something to talk about.
Yeah. There are people on here every day talking about you because you won't learn your lesson and just fuck off.
I don't care about them.
You won't learn your lesson and just fuck off.
I did.
You won't learn. They're never going to stop, Rob. They're never going to stop.
I'm not talking about them.
Never.
I'm talking about you. I don't care about them. I'm talking about you and Jay. I could give a fuck less about all these other idiots who make fake accounts. I'm talking about the people that are pussy enough, that know me, that have my number, that live in my area, that run on the Instagram, but won't say face to face. At least half of these trolls are overseas. They can't do anything. They have an excuse. But you're right down the fucking street. You got a problem? Come and tell me.
No, you already know what my problem is, Rob. There's nothing to talk about.
No, you made that whole shit up about the hospital because I apologized for that. I was super nice to you.
Bullshit! My father was on his fucking deathbed when you came at me with that shit back in May.
That's not even...
He was fucking dying!
Stop making up excuses, you fat fuck.
Really?
That's not true at all. We were talking.
Hold on, I'll be right back. I gotta go grab a light. I'll be right back.
Grab
Why don't you
light?
Read the comments, see what they think about you?
Why don't you grab a gun and shoot yourself, you fat piece of shit? Oh.
Ugh. Oh, he went away? I just went to go grab a fucking lighter. Neo anime girl, yeah, he's on something. That's what everyone keeps telling me. Oh my God. You know, one of the funnier things that Rob said is that when he saw me using the hammer strength, I put 2 10-pound weights on him. And Rob seems to forget, which the people on my chat, they know, that back in January last year, the same time last year, I injured my right shoulder. So when he saw me, I was rehabbing. But hey, yeah, whatever. I'm a weak, fat, disgusting, coward, fucking Cuban. Everybody ready? Brace yourselves. Oh, shit. Who's this? I thought it was Rob requesting me. Hello, anybody there? Are you live? Anybody there? Except. Dom lifts. Who hasn't Rob tried to fight from the Misfits? Fish not YOLO. Why is Rob crying? This person keeps requesting me, but he declined. And why does he keep? Anyway. All right, guys, brace yourselves. Here we go.
Bro, you keep saying that. Who haven't I fought with in the Misfits? You're completely wrong. I'm on good turn.
No, I just read a comment, Rob. Calm down. I just read a comment. Someone asked a question.
Oh, they teach you how to read in Cuba? That's interesting. So anyway,
yeah,
I'm cool with Andrew. I talked to Andrew yesterday. I'm completely cool with everybody that you're not cool with, bro. They think you're a joke. We did you a favor inviting
See, now you're back. Lying, Rob.
No,
now you're lying.
No, I'm not.
Now you're lying, Rob.
Ask him.
You're lying about Andrew, Rob.
No, I'm not.
I know you're
lie,
lying,
bro.
About Andrew.
I don't need to lie like you do. I don't know.
I know you're lying about
you
Andrew.
You want me to send you the snap, the screenshots? I'll send them to you.
Sure, sure.
Ask Andrew yourself. That's even better. Ask Andrew yourself because Andrew does not lie.
I will.
Ask Andrew.
I will.
Yourself, you fucking. You came to the podcast with your hair gelled, all excited. This is my 15 minutes of fame, like a fucking fat fucking bitch in your girlfriend's car. That red shitty Kia or whatever the fuck it was. You had to have your girlfriend's car because you can't even afford your own because you're broke. You work at Publix in your 40s. You're a pathetic fucking loser, dude. That's why you hang out with Jay Masters. You're a fucking loser.
That's right. We're part of the losers club.
That's facts. And no disrespect to your father because I know my Big Larry was friends with them and said your dad was a cool guy. I didn't know that till now, but... I mean, disrespect to his son. You're an embarrassment being in that gym with him. You want to tell me you were rehabbing? You're full of shit, dude. Do a video tomorrow of hammer strength machine with even 245s, which a fucking average female could do. You are pathetic, bro. You're pathetic. Stick to, like, posting memes all day. That's the best you're going to do in life. Bagging groceries and posting memes. The meme queen junior. The conservative kitten. The little bitch, pussy, who won't even meet me face-to-face for a conversation. I'm not saying I'm going to fight you. Just tell me what your problems are instead of running to YouTube and Instagram like a modern-day coward millennial. That's exactly what you are, bro. And you can't.
And what do you do when you run to Instagram, Rob, and you dox people? What is that?
I'd much rather meet them face-to-face, but the problem is everybody nowadays is cowards and just wants to go online. I've tried multiple times to call you and meet up, and you know that. Don't deny it. And you don't answer your phone for nothing.
I have no reason. I have no reason to meet up with you, Rob.
No,
I got no reason to meet up with you.
You clearly have shit to talk about me. You clearly have things on your mind about me.
You're a public figure, Rob. You decided to be
a public
figure.
Dude.
Everyone can talk about you, Rob.
I'm not a public figure. Don't.
You are. If you're in charge of a YouTube channel that has almost 30,000 followers,
you
are a public figure. When
you
decided to come down here.
You don't know shit, dude. Shut up.
When you decided to come down here and be part of the Misfits, you decided to be a public figure. Even Brad has said it. You decided to do that.
Shut your fat mouth. I can smell your breath from here, you stinky Cuban Mexican spick. Shut your fucking mouth.
That's my next IG name. That's my next IG username.
Your next IG should be RIP Daddy. I'll see you soon, you fucking clown. I'll piss on his grave. How about that? You're wrong.
Did you find it?
Figure? Bro, I had 2,000 followers on Instagram, and you losers wake up and think about me.
No, you were filming for Lenny.
Bro,
you wanted to be part of the Misfits. You are a public figure.
Lenny's a public figure. I had 2,000 followers on Instagram, and you're that obsessed with me, bro? You're pathetic. Aren't you? How do you look at yourself in the mirror? I would take that car mirror down so I didn't have to look myself in it. Dude, look at you. Holy shit. You are the ugliest fat fuck I've ever seen in my life. And you have the personality to make it even worse. I can't believe you found a wife. And you have kids. I feel sorry for them. You have food stamps? You guys on food stamps? Be honest. You on food stamps? You are, right? Riviera Beach? You're on food stamps, aren't you? That's why you're laughing. You're on food stamps. Fucking wetback. That's why you're laughing. You got a
keep going, Rob. Don't stop, Rob. Keep going. Don't
you
stop. Keep going.
I'm going to end it with this. You got a problem? Come to me like a man and say it to my face. Don't run to Instagram like a little bitch and try to make a name off making fun of somebody who's not even a somebody. I'm a nobody, bro. I had 2,000 followers. And you're going to try to make your name by bashing me? You're a fucking loser, bro. Look at you. You're sitting in your good. That's not even your car. Show me the title. Show me the title to that car. It's not even your car.
Give me a moment, Rob. Hold on.
Yeah, show me the title. I want to see the title.
No. I want to show you something. You gotta understand something. I do lives from my wife's vehicle because it's easier for me to play music.
Because it's the only car you had, you fucking liar. Don't try to.
Actually, I'm walking towards my house right now, Bob, and I'm gonna show you the vehicle that I'm driving.
You're a piece of. Show me the keys, then start it up.
Oh, I will. So this right here.
You're a fucking liar, guys. Don't believe him. We knew him before that. He doesn't have his own car. He drives his girlfriend's car. There's a car seat in the back. Hold on. It's a piece of shit Kia, and he shares it at 40 years old. I get it, bro. If you're 20 and you're starting out, but you're 40.
Hold on, let me get a flashlight. Hold on.
Nobody wants to see that ugly piece of shit car. Nobody wants to hear your fucking disgusting.
That's it, Rob. Keep him entertained.
I will keep him entertained. Unlike you, who has to fucking bash other people to make try to make a name for yourself, Mr. 400 followers. How many subscribers you got? Two? How many subscribers you got? 20? 20 losers that all have dead dads that need some sort of fucked up role model so they cling to you and Jay? That's what you got. You're a fucking clown, bro, and you know it. You deep down, you know it. That's why you're drinking right now. It's a fucking Monday night, and you got to get drunk to deal with who you are as a person. You got to wake up every day, look in the mirror when you take a shower, and see a flabby, disgusting piece of human
filth. All right, everybody, you see that?
So you got to drink yourself to see. Oh, what is it? Show the emblem. Show the emblem. Get the keys. See? Go in it.
Hold on. It's a Ford. See that?
It's Ford, an SUV. Shit.
Now here we go.
So why do you never drive it then?
Just for Robbie.
Why don't you ever drive it?
Oh, I drive it all the time. It's just I don't do lives from it because it's not convenient for me to play music. And
you think people really
everyone's heard that sound. Everyone that has heard my lives, they've heard that sound. And there we go.
Okay, congratulations. Look at that. Congratulations.
Look at that.
Pathetic as I thought, but you're still pathetic.
Look at that.
You got to wake up
and trust me, Rob, just for you, I will get someone to film me at a gym doing at least one plate on each side.
Show me that you own it. I mean, that's like a $10,000 car. In your 40s, you should at least own that, right? Don't tell me you're still making payments on it, are you? You're making payments on it.
Oh, wait a minute. I got to show you my other vehicle.
Oh,
I got another one.
Oh, yeah. I forgot you're balling. How much they pay you to slice the meat at Publix, you fucking liar? It must be your grandpa.
I got this black Chevy Trailblazer right here.
I know how the Cubans act. There's probably like 16 people living in your fucking living room. So it's definitely not your car. It's somebody else's. I want to see.
Oh, yeah, dude. We got 12 people packed up in here. They're all in sleeping bags.
At least eight. I should just call immigration to your fucking address if you ever send it to
me. You should. Yes, you should. You should call immigration on me. That'll be great.
I mean, I'm all for the immigrants who work hard, but we don't need people like you coming to this country who just run your mouth all day, post memes, make friends with the fucking biggest walrus blubber boy loser fuck in the planet. How do you live with yourself? Honestly, how do you live with yourself?
Rob, you really sound really fat phobic right now.
Well, I think the whole world is, honestly, except for fat people, because they're in denial. So that's the truth. Nobody wants to be fat. Do you like to be fat? When you look in the mirror before you get in the shower, are you pleased? Answer that. Are you happy with your physique when you look at yourself in the mirror?
Hell no. That's why I'm losing weight.
You're not losing weight, dude. You'll lose weight for like a week, and then you're going to go back to eating fucking yodels and shit. Don't try to fool yourself. Once a fat guy, always a fat guy. Don't try to fool yourself. Oh, going keto. But how did keto work out for Jay? He gets down to 310 and then back to 330 within 2 weeks. Don't fucking try to fool yourself or anybody on here. They're not that stupid, bro. How about your wife? What's your wife look like? Or is it a girlfriend? I don't know if you can afford a ring or not.
No, she's my wife. She's exactly she's exactly the way you described her, Rob. She's a hippo. She's exactly the way you described her.
That's what I figured. I figured like if you put a wig on one of those balls outside of Target, it probably looks like that.
Her skin is bad. She's fucking chafing, all kinds of shit.
You know, there's truth behind every joke, and you're deflecting right now because you know I'm right. She's an ugly fucking piece of shit, and you know it. That's the best you can get, dude. You work at Publix. What girl wants to marry some guy who works at Publix? I mean, if you were good looking and had muscles, maybe you can get laid working at Publix. No one wants to marry the fucking Publix guy. She must be atrocious. Prove me wrong, dude. Post a picture of her. Prove me wrong. Another beer to deal with The fact that you got to wake up and be you. In the another burp. Yeah. Oh, you're cool. That was funny in maybe second grade, bro. Burping and farting. Is that what do you and Jay do when you hang out? Burp and fart in each other's mouth?
No, we get into bed butt naked and we spoon.
I knew it. And this is, like I said, truth behind every joke. So how many?
I usually, when he comes into town, I go to Walmart. I get a kiddie pool. I get a bunch of oil and a bunch of mayonnaise, and we fucking lather each other with it.
That's what everybody figured. So thanks for confirming that. How many kids you got? 2?
No, I got 3.
And, okay, I feel very sorry for them. Having you, imagine being a young kid. Your father, at least he looked like a decent guy, like he accomplished something in his life. Imagine looking up to somebody as daddy and it's you. Oh my God, I'd kill myself. Are they on antidepressants?
Yeah, they're ready to throw themselves off a fucking building or in front of a fucking bus, man.
Just remember that you have 3 people relying on you to teach them how to live, and look how you act, bro, in your 40s. Look how you act. They're relying on you to make an example, and you're sitting in your car talking to fucking losers at 7 o'clock on a Monday drinking.
Oh, just remember, everyone. Rob just called you all losers. Just remember that.
Not all, but most of them. Most of them are losers. Anybody who tunes into your shit to think that you're cool is a loser. Most people are here to laugh at you, bro. Most people are here to laugh at you. They can laugh at me all they want. I'm comfortable with my life. I get laid. I enjoy my life. But you, I know that you're trying to fucking mask everything, drinking 3 beers already within an hour on a fucking Monday. You hate your life, bro. You're miserable. That's why you take it out on me. That's why these trolls, they take it out on me. They're fucking miserable, and they're looking for something to blame it on. So they point to me. All I did was make YouTube videos with my friend. That's not a reason to be harassed. I've been harassed more than somebody who fucking kills their wife. That's not a reason. Because I make videos with my friend, I get harassed like this. It's not right. It's people like you who have serious psychological issues and need someone to blame their pain on. It's not me, bro. Go to a shrink. Cut down on the beer. Go to a shrink. Lose that weight like you're planning to do, but it's not me, man. Coming after me is not going to do anything. Maybe I already got fired from my job because of you guys. Do you feel accomplished now? What does that do for you? Does that pay your bills, getting me fired? Does that pay your bills, getting me fired? What does that
do? Hold on, Rob, did you get fired?
I want you to answer this. Me getting fired, now, okay, so now that's done. So what does that do for you guys? You guys happy now? You're happy fucking with someone's livelihood like that? That makes you happy? That makes you happy. Answer my question. Tell me how this benefits your life right now. How does that benefit
your life? So, Rob, you got fired?
Over some silly YouTube drama, I may or may not have been fired. So how do you feel about that? That makes you feel like a big man? Getting somebody fired from their job? You feel accomplished? What does that do for your life? Answer me, bro. Answer me. What does that do for your life?
Me? I'm not the one who's fucking doxing you.
Bro, you're contributing, so shut the fuck up. You're contributing.
Contributing? You're the one who's contributing, Rob. You're the one who's giving them all of the ammunition.
No, I'm not, dude. I didn't come on here.
Not at all.
No, not until a couple days ago when this shit started getting really bad and Brad messaged me and warned me about some shit going on Instagram. So I logged in to check it out and see what's going on. And everybody's trying to fucking dox me. Jay's got all his fake accounts, that Rocky Raccoon shit. I know that, Jay. And I know you were in those groups, those private groups with Jay, because some of those guys actually felt bad for me and sent me the pictures and the screenshots of those groups. And it's you and Jay in there convincing people to get me fired. Okay, so that happened. Now what? You feel happy with yourself?
Can you send me those screenshots?
No, I don't want to send you. Do you make any money off that? Answer my question.
No.
How does this benefit you, getting me fired? How does that benefit you? You feel good now? You're a good man sitting in your fucking car drinking beer on a Monday night? You feel big and bad? Getting people.
Rob, you need to send me those screenshots.
I don't need to.
People are entitled. They want to see them.
Nobody's entitled.
People want to see those screenshots.
I've done enough for all these people. I've done more than enough. More than enough. And they want to point the finger at me and say, I'm a drug addict. How about the 100 times Lenny begged me to go take him to smoke crack and I denied him? Or when he said, Rob, you should try smoking crack. It's great. What kind of friend tries to get another friend to smoke crack? So Lenny's a piece of shit. I'll go on record saying that. I did my video the other night biting my tongue. saying I love them. I don't. Any friend who betrays another friend like that and is willing to destroy their livelihood, especially Lenny, after his was destroyed by this shit, and he's willing to do that to me, someone who's done more for him than anybody. I don't care. Marvin spent money on him. It takes more to give somebody your time and your effort and your fucking life. I've done so much for that guy, and for him to turn on me, fuck him. I'm done with all this shit. I never changed the password, so stop fucking saying that, dude. I never changed. I'm not that low. I'm not as low as him. I'm not gonna fuck with his income just because he fucked with mine.
And I started this live telling everyone that you're vehemently denying that narrative.
For days you've been pushing that narrative just to give people a reason to go after me. Everybody deep down knew. Why the fuck would I change your password? I set my video on private, the ones I did, the ones I fucking drove an hour to him, filmed, and then drove an hour back. I set those on private for two reasons. One, because all you trolls right now are going to start spamming the place I work, which you guys did. And then two, he doesn't deserve to make another dollar off all the effort I put into him. And everyone says, oh, you were making money too. Dude, I was not. I took a small percent those months I was filming. I don't take anything from him anymore. And his whole fucking channel is things that I've done for him. Out of 300 videos, at least 220 are videos that I did for him. So yeah, I made him private to kind of show him, you know, fuck you, as a little fuck you, and I'll send him back eventually. But I never changed his password. I'm not that low, dude. He still makes money from that channel. I'm not gonna, I did all this to give him a monthly income. I'm not gonna take that away from him, even though I hate him.
So yeah, you're denying that you took away Lenny's access to the YouTube. He actually has access to it.
Don't ask me like you're Judge Judy, dude. Everybody knows the fucking answer. I'm not that fucking low and immature. I have other things to worry about.
So Lenny's lying.
Lenny never said that, so don't say Lenny's lying. If anything, Lenny logged himself out and doesn't know how to log back in, but I sent him the password multiple times in case he lost it. So Lenny never said that. I know that for a fact. Don't try to make shit up. And if Lenny had trouble logging into the account, he could have called me. Or I gave McLeod the account today in case he, in the future, if he has trouble logging in, so he can go log him in on his phone like I used to have to do. I used to have to drive out there just to log him back into his account because he doesn't know how to do it. This is the person we're dealing with. So I've made my point, dude. I'm fucking done. Once Lenny goes back, once I know he's good and he's back to doing his thing, I'll never post from his account again. The Instagram will be deleted, or he never uses it anyway, so no point in keeping it. But if he wants it, if he can have the Instagram, I want nothing to do with this shit. You can have it, bro. You want it so bad, you can have it. And when they start fucking with your life for no reason other than you trying to be entertaining to them, tell me how you like it.
Okay.
I've done my part, bro. I've done my part. I gave that dude almost a year of driving out there an hour every day to pick him up, filming, driving back. You want to know the truth? At the time I was filming for him every day, he took like 70% and I took 30. And that's nothing, dude. I was doing all the fucking work. I drove out there to pick him up. I brought him there. I edited the videos. I set up the podcast. I set up the networking. I paid all the little fees that come with the podcast. I did absolutely everything. And I barely got shit in return. So I didn't take any money from his cameos or anything like that. So he was doing pretty fucking well for himself. I did nothing wrong, dude. That's why I get on here and defend myself, because I did nothing. I wish I had a friend like I was to Lenny. I would kill for a friend like that. Someone to come out, drive me around all fucking day, take me grocery shopping because I don't have a car, with no questions asked. There was days I didn't even film. And I drove him up there just to, like, he needed to run an errand or something. It's a 45-minute drive each way, dude. Like, and these people apparently love Lenny, and they're going to fucking harass the one person that fucking actually gave a shit enough to help this guy out and do everything he fucking could in that time to help him out, to the point where I couldn't even pay my bills anymore because I got so wrapped up in this shit. I lost my car and stuff because we weren't making enough money, but it felt better to me that we were giving the maniacs something every fucking day. Almost every day, we were providing them with something, and that felt better to me than making money. So I kept doing it, and now everyone wants to turn around and make me the bad guy. Dude, that's wrong. I've done nothing but try to help that guy. People forget this. People forget the idea of Lenny having his own channel was just an idea before I got here. I'm the one who took the initiative to go meet up with him, tell him, start filming, edit. Dude, that channel has been up for over 30 months. The least he's made is $250 a month, up to like $2,000. He's had a check for over 30 months now because of something I did for him. And I'm not trying to take credit for it. I'm just proving my character. I didn't ask him for a cut until I was going there every day and I needed fucking gas to put in my car to get there. Yeah, I asked him for a little bit, but in the beginning, all that shit was just to help him. Or at the club. He was making good money at the club. He didn't do shit. I did his whole job for him. I was security. He got hired to clean. Who do you think cleaned every night? Me. And I didn't care because that's how I treat my friends. I'm a good friend to people I really care about. But once you cross me, and it wasn't the first time he crossed me either. There was a week I couldn't film after Miami. And he runs and says to Brad, yeah, Rob hasn't come up here in a couple of days. I think I'm going to get a new cameraman. I don't know what's wrong with him. I can easily make a post and get a new cameraman. After I just took him to Miami, gave him the best video he's ever done, he pukes in my fucking car and leaves it there, doesn't tell me. And then he's bitching at me because I was sick and I couldn't come up there for a few days. And I ended up forgiving him for that. Within a day, I forgave him. And then there was other instances that happened. And I always kept it in my head. Lenny's a good guy, dude. Lenny, he just doesn't know any better, but he's a good guy. So this final thing happened, he proved to me he's a fucking asshole. And he's been trying to turn me against Fiedelman since day one that I've been here. And that's why I reached out to Andrew yesterday. I said, you were always right. Lenny had me wrapped around his finger. And I'm sorry for anything negative I've ever said about you because you didn't deserve that. And I lost a good friend over someone who is a master manipulator. That's the fucking truth.
Well, there you have it, everyone.
Yeah, so you can thank me later, bro, because I just made your life something that'll go down in Genovaverse history. But, dude, to be honest, bro, the things I say about you and your family and your father, that's just to get you to try to meet up with me or to call me. Dude, I never had an issue with you. I always liked you, man. That's why when you started saying shit or whatever, going on lives, I was so taken aback and it got me so angry because I'm like, dude, I was always nice to this fucking guy. Every time I seen him at the gym, he was nice to my face. So I was like, did he always not like me and just never said anything until now? Like, what the fuck is the deal? I didn't know you were that upset about me texting you that week, and I'm sorry, but Jay was harassing my family that week, and I completely forgot about your situation when I text you, and I'll apologize for that, bro. I'm sorry about that, and I'm sorry about the crazy things I said, but you got to understand, man, I'm being harassed at all angles by people, and I don't necessarily deserve it. There's just so much misinformation going around trying to make me out to be some fucking asshole that I'm not.
Jay, all right, I'm going to say this, everyone. We need to save Rob's job.
No, don't.
Everyone listen to me and save Rob's job. No, just stop. Just stop.
Please don't. I don't want them doing anything with the job. Just leave me alone. That's what I want. Just leave me the fuck alone. Don't contact anybody. That's all I want. And Jay, I'm sorry for his situation with his job, but he's got to realize, dude, he came after me like he came after other people, and he finally met his match. He finally met someone that said, oh, yeah, you want to fucking play like that? I'll play like that, too. And then, you know, he got a taste of his own medicine. He can't be bitter about that. And the answer to that is not to do it again. I don't want to ever fuck with somebody's livelihood, never. But if you fuck with mine, it's only fair that I fuck with yours. So I'll take this platform here to say, Jay, sorry for that situation, but you got to grow up and realize that you had a big part in that too. I'm fucking 29 years old. You're in your 50s, man. Come on. Move on to bigger and better things. But I want to be done with this shit. I don't want anything to do with this shit anymore. If people want to contact me, they can find my email online, MrZilla@protonmail.com, and that's it.
All right, everyone, there you have it. Now we got to hear from Lenny. Let's see if Lenny will come out of woodwork and say something.
Well, I posted his number. You can call him. It's anything. But all right, man, have a good night.
All right, everyone, there you go. That's what you wanted. You're entitled. And there you go. So let's get back to the comments since that happened. But going back to let's focus again, okay? Since this morning, Rob has been vehemently denying that he, you know, Rob's been vehemently denying that he took away Lenny's access to YouTube, right? And so what I'm saying is everyone needs to contact Lenny and ask Lenny to either do a live with me or to do a live on YouTube and explain some things. So, and I think right now everyone needs to lay off Rob. Everyone needs to lay off Rob for right now. We need to find out what's going on with Lenny. All right, so let's get to the comments. I'm going to start. All right. Pickpool Sigma, leave him alone, man. Jesse Scalf, clearly he was fucking freaking out and hiding that behind trying to be tough guy. Seamus Robinson, double down on Rob. Shark Killer 99, Rob, get what deserve. Mr. Fun 70, Robzilla is promoting nootropics. Tower 1, how about a Zoom with Cuban, Rob, and Lenny? Oof. Big J's 45, order 66 on Rob. Mike 1-2, trolls killed the misfits. Wreck it for true maniacs. Eli Chambers 97, Lenny's too lazy to go live. Edward Vic 18, Porch Monkey Zilla, Mad Lives Matter. He really bipolar swung there, just needs to never come back. Arnbood, Rob puts himself into the situation, get what deserve, woo. Getting Rob fired, bye bye post office. Guys, I'm telling you, for right now, you gotta trust me, just for right now, just, I'm not telling you to stop. Okay, how about that? I'm not telling you to stop. I'm just telling you, just stand down for a moment and let's wait to hear from Lenny. Because somebody's lying. Somebody's lying. So we need to hear to wait. We need to hear from Lenny. Ric Flair's last food. Need Rob, Lenny, Jay live deal as moderator. It debating. Louis V Jedi, what are your thoughts on the whole situation anyway? Edward Vic 18, who did Lenny tell about Rob's job at the post office? Lenny needs to answer that. Lenny is the one who needs to answer that. Lord Deathspit. Oh, welcome back. Legit, whoever got Lenny fired from the hospital ruined the Misfits. Lenny needed the internet for money. Okay, see, now that's another thing, okay? Do we really know that Big Rab got Lenny fired? Do we really know that? Old fleece booty bandit, did Brad put a collar on you and let you fuck his hair? Not yet. Not yet. Tower One, Rob made some valid points. Don't think Rob is fully to blame from the sound of it. That's why I am saying people need to start messaging Lenny right now. Everyone needs to start messaging Lenny right now to either go live with me, either now or another scheduled time. Or he needs to do a live on Instagram, or he needs to do a live on YouTube explaining everything. Because as of right now, Rob vehemently denies taking away Lenny's YouTube from him. He vehemently denies that. So we need to hear from Lenny. Lord Leonard Tan 1010, Lenny can't go live. A Bell. He's on crack, too busy. Yeah, can't talk. Pitbull Sigma, Lenny doesn't know what live is. Getting Rob fired, can't trust a drug addict. Mike 1-2, Big Rob Fitness should never been let into the Genovaverse. Eli Chambers 97, I'm pretty sure Lenny just doesn't know how to work his phone. Hold on. Van City Sean W. Call him. Irig, nothing in reserve. Lenny's too busy eating and sleeping for live, you cookie cutter. Lord Deathspit, what if Lenny just lost the password? Now, hold on a minute. Remember what Rob just said. Rob said that he reached out to Lenny, and he sent something to Lenny to help him gain access to the YouTube. So, here we go. Stufer 2002. Didn't McLeod find out who got Lenny fired? Okay, so here's the question. Wasn't McLeod the one who said that it was Big Rob that called up the hospital and got Lenny fired? No. He sent them the video of Lenny doing the porn. Maurice 1990, Moldzilla getting loud in the city's too funky Cuban music. It is meant of the century. Chuck E. Cheese Ranch, what did I miss? Chucky, I'm going to post this. And I know what you're going to do, because you are the documentor. Chuck E. Cheese Ranch is the documentor. Whatever happened here, I got to live with. He's going to post it because you guys deserve it. You're fucking entitled. Chuck E. Cheese Ranch, I'm going to post this and you'll see everything. Light Brown Alpine, father isn't winning. I called up his contractor, LOL. He's about to be investigated. Getting Rob fired, what drug cocktail was Rob on, Cuban? Mr. J2E. Dude, I thought you're recorded. Tower One Cuban, how about just call Lenny live. Well, how I'm doing this live right now, this is my own personal cell phone, so I can't, and I'm not going to use my wife's or one of my kids' cell phones. It's not happening. Now, hold on a minute. Can I, even though, let's, okay, here's a question, because you guys will be able to answer this. I'm doing this live right now. Is there any way for me right now to send a request to Lenny, even though he's not watching this live? Is there a way for me to do that? Let me see something. Let me see something. Let's go to search. Nah. Mike 1 2, hey from down under. So you're in Australia. Okay, Chuck E. Cheese Ranch, what I did was I went to where it says invite to join, and I put on the search, you know, his username, and it doesn't come up. So I would imagine that he would have to be here on this live for me to invite him. If anyone knows another way. Shark Killer 99, Rob is the one who started all of the doxing. Light Brown Alpine, call Lenny and restart. Guys, if I call him and I have him on the phone with me, I don't think it's going to let me go back to doing a live. Eli Chambers, end this live. Quickly call Lenny and tell him to go live. $51.50 for $59.50. Call him on loudspeaker while you are live. It won't affect the stream. Let me take a quick piss. Hold on a minute. Chuck E. Cheese Ranch, Lenny at Mistress Hazel's house, unfortunately, has something in the mouth. Listen, guys, here's the thing. Here's how I know that Lenny, if he sees me calling him, he's not gonna answer. I already had someone close to me get in touch with Lenny so that Lenny could go live with me. And Lenny is saying that he is having he's having issues with his phone. So like I said, sometime this week, I'm supposed to meet up with Lenny. And we're going to see what happens. So. Kev 69 IG, you're a hard-working man, Cuban. No, I'm a piece of shit, fat ass, ugly fucking Cuban fucking loser that works at a bag boy that works as a bag boy at Publix, and my wife is a hippo, and my kids are at the brink of suicide because I'm such a shitty person. All right, let me see something. Let me see something, guys. Hold on a minute. All right, you guys are still there. Were you there the whole time as I was doing something? Right now, I just text Lenny. And I asked Lenny if he wants to go live with me on IG to explain his side of what Rob Zilla's story. So let's see if I get a response. For those of you that are just coming back, I just text Lenny. So let's see if Lenny... So, Blah Wire 1550, will you post this live? Of course I will. I do. I post all of them. Can you guys still see me? Is this me, John Wayne? Is this you? All right. Oh, what a shit show. I mean, it's exactly what Andrew talks about, a fucking conveyor belt of shit. So guys, I'm going to reiterate, okay? Rob is vehemently denying that he took away Lenny's access to YouTube, okay? I think, not that you guys are going to listen to me or anything, but I think maybe you guys need to stand down and let's hear Lenny's side, okay? I sent him a text. He hasn't texted me back. Someone very close to me got in contact with Lenny and asked Lenny if he could go live with me. And Lenny's claiming problems with his phone. Chuck E. Cheese Ranch, A Piss River Runs Through It. That's actually a great title for this live, Chuck E. Cheese Ranch. I recommend and endorse that you use that title when you post this on your YouTube. Uncle Dave's Last Dealer is back. Holy shit. Louis V. Jedi, Lenny and Andrew are not no good terms. What happened? That's up to Lenny and Andrew to discuss. Bradford Mail Prick, Mercy does not exist in Lake Crespa. Oh, I know. I know it doesn't exist. See, Rob is still here. And I'm being fair, Rob. I think everyone just stand down, and we need to hear from Lenny. Somebody's lying, and we need to hear from Lenny. Chuck E. Cheese Ranch, it's just all a big misunderstanding, but taking down the videos out of spite makes it seem like revoked access to Lenny. Eli Chambers, Lenny will just come on here and spew a bunch of nonsense like he always does. He never owns up to his mistakes. Rob, if you're watching this, I'm supposed to meet up with Lenny this week. And I've already discussed this with other people. And I've been warned that he is going to lie right to my face. Maybe that's not a fair statement. He's not here to defend himself. But I've already been told he may lie right to my face. So we're going to find out. Cataluna, Data, Cuban, the savior of the Misfits. No, dude, the Misfits are done. It's done. Okay? The Misfits were this great band, this great television show, or whatever, however you want to look at it, okay? As soon as one person in a band or in a television show thinks that they're more important than everyone else, everything just goes to shit. So, all I know is if I don't meet up with Lenny this week, Lenny can't hide forever, okay? Lenny cannot hide forever. And it'll further, if Lenny hides and he doesn't have a conversation with me about this, it will further prove Rob right. I mean, we're talking common sense here, okay? Rob, again, I'm going to beat you guys over the head with this. Rob is vehemently denying that he took away Lenny's access to YouTube. We need to hear from Lenny. And I've said that before too. What Rob did for Lenny, who else is going to do that? Father even said that. Jay even said that. Who else is going to do that for Lenny? Okay? Filming for Lenny is literally a full-time fucking job. So, just like the old Chris Isaac song, "Oh, somebody's lying. Oh, somebody's lying." Past assignment is always two sides every story, as I said the other night. Yeah, we need to hear from Lenny. Is Rob vehemently defended his position? Is Lenny willing to vehemently defend his position? So, and I know you guys are not going to listen to me, but everyone, stand down. you're hearing this from me, stand down on Rob until we find, I mean, at least find out what's going on with Lenny. So I don't think there's anything else to talk about. Light brown Alpine, LOL, not talking so much smack anymore. Funny how Cuban changed once confronted. No, I changed once Rob apologized. Rob apologized, guys. There are those of you that were waiting for that. There were those of you that wanted that. There were those of you that were asking for that. Rob apologized. What else is there to talk about? Rob apologized. Rob vehemently said that he wants nothing to do with any of this shit anymore. Sir Flyness 86, I think. Let me, Sir Flyness 86, Lenny, oh god damn it, Lenny has a lot of explaining to do. Louis V Jedi, I think Rob made great points. Human Young, get what deserves. DL365 24/7. Say vehement again. With Rob, that's the only way I can clarify how Rob is stating things. He is vehemently denying it. Glenfinnan in Scotland. McLeod is calling for a Del Rey mania. Official Jason Cruznova. Rob, just stop. Ken Daniels, why did it take 2 years for Rob apology? Shark Killer 99, you can't insert yourself into this and then just leave, Bobby. Why can't he just hold on a minute? Let's talk about this logically. Because there are those of you, and Rob is on here, there are those of you that don't want to see him again. What if he were to just walk away? Isn't that what you want? Come on, guys, let's go through it. Let's go through the fucking logic. You guys wanted to be rid of Robzilla. He's willing to fucking walk away. He said it. Pastor Simon, I said this last night, only Janoi Crespa can bring back balance to the Genovaverse. Yes. Yes. Chuck E. Cheese Ranch, Robzilla. Is that Lenny? Sorry about that, guys. Someone texted me, and I thought for a moment it may have been Lenny, and it wasn't him. Lenny, so right now, Lenny has gone silent on me, which is, that is not a good sign. For Lenny not to text me back, because Lenny's good at texting back. He's good at DMing back, and he isn't. That's not good. That's not good. That's not a good sign. We're going to see what happens this week. I'm dead serious about meeting him. So we're going to find out what the fuck's going to happen. I'll be right back. But remember what I said, everyone. Everyone should be messaging Lenny right now and telling him to either go live with me or do an Instagram live or a YouTube live defending his position. Pinga. De pinga. Yeah. De pinga. Official Jason Cruz Nova, you literally screamed on a live, had a racist take when you know this video is going to go on YouTube. Who, me? Hold on a minute. I'm a Mexican fat shit of peace. I'm entitled to be racist. If you're talking about me. Glenfin in Scotland. Cuban, talk to McLeod if you can't get Lenny. He has said he is not so innocent and as everyone thinks. You guys would be surprised what McLeod and I have talked about. Ric Flair's last woo. Lenny is with the Lot Lizard PMs enjoying its 10. MC, Jesus, some of your usernames, man, it's hard. How about this? Okay, I'm gonna spell out MCIANI95. What position are you at? Publix. I work there too. According to Jay Masters, I work in the bakery and have a hairnet, and I wear an apron. Ric Flair's last room, McCuck knows all. I believe it. Johnny Kills, you all followed Lenny because you thought he had good character and morals. Fuck no. Everyone watched a train wreck. Yeah, that's why after this live, having Rob come on here defend his position, he's apologized to me, he's apologized to Jay. Now the ball is in Lenny's court. The ball is in Lenny's court now. And it sounded like to me that Rob is done. He's done with all of this shit. And he's fucking moving on. And all I'm saying is, not that you're going to fucking listen to me. All I'm saying is, just stand down for a moment and let's see Lenny. Let's see if Lenny defends his fucking position. Yes, Zach, apologies to Jay. He apologized. It's on here. And I'm going to post it. Chuck E. Cheese Ranch is going to upload it for the whole fucking world to see. So. I'm gonna smoke this cigarette and end this live because there's nothing. That's it. I mean, we're beating a dead horse. We're beating a dead horse. We allowed Rob to come out here, vent his frustrations, vent his grievances, give me all he's got, and at the end he apologized. So, what is left? What's left is Lenny. It sounds like Lenny needs to defend his position. So. And you guys got to understand something. It's because of my father and everything. That's why I went so hard on Rob. Rob has apologized. I'm a man. I'm willing to fucking move on. If Rob, listen guys, if Rob needs to apologize for more, if he needs to apologize to another person, that's between him and that other person. It's got nothing to do with me. He apologized to me. So, I got some questions. Hold on a minute. Locatero, where's Jason? Dom lifts. Who hasn't Rob tried to fight for him? Okay. JP US 1 La Candela, boom boom La Candela. JP US 1 hello Edmano. God damn it. Anyway. Human Young Cuban, don't go soft, bruh. Well, let me ask you a question. Rob was willing to come on this live with me. He was brave enough to do that. He aired everything he needed to air out. He vented everything he needed to vent out, and at the end, he apologized. What kind of an asshole would I be if I didn't accept the fucking apology? So, Robzilla Cuban, I can't hate you face to face, even on a screen after. Sometimes, so please call me in the future. I didn't know you were upset. I would have made it right last year. Apologize for excessive insults. See, he just apologized again, guys. I mean, what, as far as my side of the street, what else is there to talk about? So, again, that's it. Once I'm done with a cigarette, that's it. We're beating a dead horse. Is Lenny going to defend his position? And the longer Lenny stays quiet, Gorilla Ortiz, Bobby, you fucking missed it. Bobby, you fucking missed it. But that's okay. I'm going to repost it. You'll be able to watch it. Chuck E. Cheese Ranch is going to upload it. Gorilla Ortiz, has Rob been fired? For right now, I hope not. For right now, I hope not, because we need to hear from Lenny. Lenny needs to defend his position. The longer Lenny stays silent, man, it ain't looking good. Well, earlier today, Gorilla Ortiz just asked, give me a quick recap. Well, earlier today, Rob doxed Jay and I, and I decided to do this live, and I allowed Rob to come on here, and Rob aired all of his grievances, and at the end, he apologized, and he just apologized again in the comment section. He apologized to Father, he apologized to Jay. And Rob is vehemently denying that he took away Lenny's access to his YouTube. I've had someone very close contact Lenny, spoke to him on the phone. And Lenny is coming up with excuses not to go live with me. He's coming up with excuses not to go live on his Instagram. He's coming up with excuses, and it doesn't look good. So, OmegaTron 66, Cuban has more than 50 people. It big time, dude. It was up to 150 when Rob was on here. It was up to 150 when Rob was on here. Yes, Bradford, male prick. It is vehemently. Union, it apology accepted, unfortunately. Ken Daniel 707. Kevin Cuban, this was the best live in a year. We need time to wind down. See, that's why I bring up, for instance, he might still be on here, Pastor Simon. Pastor Simon believes in confrontation therapy. And I believe in it too. Confrontation, that's how you grow. Life is a series of confrontations, okay? And this needed to happen. This live needed to happen. Rob needed to come on here. He needed to say everything that he needed to say. Okay? And now, where's Lenny? And the longer Lenny stays quiet, the worse it's looking for him. Ken Daniels, 007. Cuban, get your wife's phone and talk to Lenny with speaker phone while doing live. I don't want Lenny having my wife's phone number. The Bradford male prick, describe how this situation relates to a Goodfellas scene. I don't think it does.
Ah.
Ric Flair's last move was Lenny the Misfit's problem all along? Again, Lenny needs to defend his position. So, Jason, hold on. Jason Blaha has hair, La Candela. Let me play you a song. See, this is why I do lives from my wife's car, because her vehicle, I'm able to put in a flash drive and access most of the music that I have. I can't do that in the truck. So let me find you a song real quick here. There it is. So Jason Blaha has hair. You talk about La Candela. Listen to this song. This is a song that Rob would like if he understood it, and I'll translate.
Yo soy candela, me toca candela, la voz de aquí me prende en vela. Yo soy candela, me toca candela, la voz de aquí me prende en vela.
What the guy's saying there is, yo soy candelón, I am either the fire or the heat, and I inflict fire. And the badasses around here, they light candles for me.
Yo soy candelo, me toca candela, la voz de aquí me prende en vela.
The beer's good.
Candelo, me toca candela, la voz de aquí me prende en vela. Acabo una pandilla.
Soy una fiera,
los guapos
de Melilla me prenden vela.
Acabo una pandilla,
yo soy una fiera. Guapos de Melilla me prenden vela.
Yo soy candela, me toca candela, bravo de aquí me prenden vela. Yo soy candela, me toca candela, bravo de aquí me prenden vela. Yo no pago taquilla, plando bandera, me dicen que soy el hombre pantera.
Gorilla Ortiz, I'll send you a YouTube of this song. This artist, his name is Roberto Rowena. This is from his second album. No, Roberto Rowena is a fucking badass. His band was one of the fucking best. Bobby, listen to this shit. Listen to this. And you lost. You played your money and you lost. Okay, yo soy dichoso en el amor. But that's it, man. That's it. This has been JP US1, he's a classic. You must know much about salsa like I do. But that's it, man. We beat a dead horse, and there's nothing else to talk about. Lenny needs to defend his position. So there's nothing else to talk about. Everyone should be messaging Lenny, asking him to either go live with me, do a live on Instagram or a live on YouTube and defend his position. It's not looking good. It is not looking good at all. So, all right, man. Chuck E. Cheese Ranch. I will be posting this. Be patient as it uploads, and then do your thing. Let me check the. All right, that's it. No questions. All right, everyone. Everybody, like I said, now all we're doing is we're waiting to see what Lenny does.